Steve Dotto here. In our ongoing quest to help you reach and maintain inbox zero, no promising app will be overlooked. And this is a promising app which I thought I would share with you today. It's called Unroll.me, and it's a fairly simple app that tries to help you reach inbox zero and tries to help you get control of your inbox. Now, it turns out the folks at Unroll.me are pretty laser focused on one aspect of email overload, and that is newsletters. Now, when I first looked at their software, I thought, well, that's a fairly narrow focus. Should we really have an app that's just dedicated to helping us manage and maintain our newsletters and control those? So I kind of went into it with a little bit skeptical. The software seems to be completely free. They have no mention on their landing page here of cost. And when I went in and looked, and I've actually enrolled for it now and looked through the FAQs, can't find any mention of cost. So I apologize if they do have a cost downstream, but at this point it looks to me like it's a completely free service. One caveat, it doesn't work on your old Popmail accounts. You have to have a webmail account in order for it to work. So it only searches webmail accounts or online email accounts. But you sign up for free, and once you sign up, it takes 5, maybe 8 minutes, depending on the speed of your internet connection, and it scans your inbox and comes back with a report telling you how many subscriptions you have. And for me, this was a "what are you saying" moment, because I thought I would find 40, 50 email newsletters that I'm subscribed to. It turns out I have over 400 emails that I'm subscribed to, and I went, "What? I can't believe it." So all of a sudden, I have to tell you, my attitude towards this app changed from, "I wonder if it's going to be anything useful," to, "Holy cow, I need something like this," because I didn't realize that I basically was dealing with over 400 newsletters. Now, because I deal in tabbed email in Gmail, they're all pretty much contained in a small area. But still, 400. It's ridiculous, is it not? So what Rollup does is, first of all, they give you that kind of that moment when you realize just exactly how deep you are down the newsletter rabbit hole. They give you that, but they also give you the ability to take your different newsletters and create a roll-up with them, to kind of create a digest which pulls them all into one single email. So instead of receiving all of the emails individually in your inbox, it will create one email which will have a summary of all of the other newsletters in it, and then you can navigate through by that. So that's pretty interesting. It creates an interesting opportunity for us to then take like newsletters in the same topic area, and combine them into a digest that we can then go in and view at our leisure. So I like that idea. That seems to be very good. So what they do is they actually suggested this particular set of newsletters that I receive right out of the gate. Now, I don't think their algorithm here was exceptionally intuitive or anything, because it took Apple, Costco, Clout, Open Table, and Stumble Upon, which are free, three very different newsletters. I don't know whether they think they should combine the same type of newsletter or different. It doesn't matter. This first roll-up is not going to work for me. But the bottom line is that we'll now take all of these newsletters and combine them into one single missive that they then send to me. But here's the interesting part of this particular app. Let's go to the inbox, which has all of the newsletters that I'm subscribed to, and it'll give us an idea of how you can work with this particular piece of software. So here is all of the newsletters that I have subscribed to or been subscribed to over the years that are all still flowing into my inbox on a steady basis. So I think that there's an awful lot in here that I should be maintaining. Now, so it's going to take me some time to navigate my way through and decide what to do with these, and it'll probably take a little bit of trial and error to determine if I want them in a digest or I want to receive the emails, the newsletters still in individual emails. I suppose as somebody who sends out newsletters as a large part of my business, I'm taking a bit of a chance here in sharing this with you, because you might decide to put me into a digest, which means you might not see me quite as quickly and easily. But then I also realize that's your right. You control the flow of information in. My goal is to provide you with killer content so that I want to differentiate myself from all of the other noise there on the internet. So hopefully you'll find enough value in what I send out to keep me outside of some digest that just kind of get lost in there. But if that's the case, well, then I get what I deserve, I guess. But going through it now, there is a couple of features that are worth looking at. So the first is adding it to a roll-up. So if you find, this is a really nice little newsletter that I do like, but it's a educational newsletter. So I want to see what happens if I click on this. It's going to be added to my roll-up. So I've got a roll-up here. I don't know if I can make It's just one digest. It doesn't look like I can make multiple different roll-ups. So that it'd be nice if I could make one that's like education newsletter, one that's education, one that's social media. But that does not appear to be an option at this point. I wonder what happens if I click on new items. What does that do? Edits my subscriptions? It doesn't look like it does it. Sorry, I should know a little bit more about the app, but I don't. At any rate, so it looks like I can add them to that digest. So in that particular case there, I'm not going to add Costco to my roll-up because I think what I should be doing with Costco is unsubscribing. So I can go through now, and with all of these emails that's going to my inbox, you can work your way through it, and you can take things like Tiger Direct Affiliate Manager. I don't need that. Unsubscribe from it. Alex Moses. Oh, that Udemy. That's a site that you build. You can put online courses on. And I looked at it when I was thinking about doing when I started developing my course architecture. But I'm not going to do that. I don't need that anymore. I'm going to unsubscribe from that. See this? Add this team. Add this. .com. I don't even know what that is. I should take a look at what addthis.com is. So obviously, it's going to take me a little bit of time to work my way through. I'm down from 420 down to 418 subscriptions. But I'm going to take some time. I'm going to work my way through this, clean up my newsletter subscription world, and then hopefully it'll help me more easily maintain inbox zero. I hope you found this valuable. If you have, please. Give us a like. It's always good to let other people know that are watching the videos that it gives you something called social proof. It tells people that the videos are good when you give us a little bit of response and give us a like or make a comment about it. That adds value. And if you think there's value there, then please do that. I'm Steve Dotto. Thanks for spending time with me today.